Good morning everyone. Today we'll discuss the last portion of the second module, the amazing problem multiple stacks, multiple queues. So with some programming examples, running programs. So we'll move on to the amazing problem. Before we discuss, we'll just briefly sum up what we discussed in previous session. Like we discussed what is a queue, where we are going to insert is called as a rear, and where we are going to delete is called as a front, and the half a dozen operations, enqueuing, dequeuing, create, is empty, is full, peak, size, etc., and their respective operations, and an illustration through a simple C program, and the different types of queues, simple queue and their applications, circular queue and their applications, priority queue and its applications, and followed by double-ended queue and a simple program illustration, and also in detail the circular queues, the different operations that are applicable, and in detail the programs, program implementation of circular queue in terms of arrays and in terms of dynamic allocated arrays. And also we implemented the concept of the DQ, the particular DQ where insertions and removals are happening at either ends, and the operations and the priority queue were discussed in the previous class. And for today we will discuss the mazing problem. Like a rat is going to be there within a maze, and it has to start from a particular position and it has to end up to a particular position, and here 1 is going to be barrier for it and 0 is going to be a person for that. Like if the element is 0, then we can go through that particular cell. So say here it is going to be 0 0, and here it is going to be 1 1 1, it is going to be 2 2, and it is going to be n cross n. So you consider n cross n matrix as a maze, and you start from a particular cell and you end up a particular cell, where the rat has to start its journey and it has to end up with, say, like it has to traverse like this, and it has to go like this, and it has to come up like this, like this, like this, and end up with this particular cell, starting from here and it has to end up here. So 0 means open path, 1 is the barriers and border conditions. So that we should not breach out the barriers, borders, we indicate all the borders by 1, all the borders by 1. So it need not necessarily a square matrix, but it can be of m cross p maze, and it will require m plus 2 into p plus 2, because here 1 column is going to be added and here 1 column is going to be added. That is why column is going to be added 2 by 2, and here 1 row and top 1 row. So 2 rows, 2 columns are going to be extra. So you need a matrix, which is going to be 2 rows extra, 2 rows, 2 columns extra. So we assume that the 1 cross 1 to be the 1 cross 1 to be the starting position, and arbitrary m cross p to be the exit position. So understanding about these basic assumptions of this basic problem, we will further proceed with how we are going to solve it using the data structures and a C program. So to the basic understanding of this basic problem will be like this. Say assume the rat to be there in any particular place or in any particular cell of this matrix. Say consider this cell, it is going to be having an index of 1 and 1. Say if this is going to be like 0, 1, 1 and 2. So this is going to be, this cell is going to have an indices of 1, comma 2. So likewise, each cell is going to be having some index. This is quite understandable. And having this understanding, assuming that a rat is going to be there in a particular cell, and it has to decide on in which direction it has to move. Say if the rat is going to be there in this particular cell, say in this row and in this column, if it is present here, then in which and all directions it can move. It can move in all 8 directions, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So to move in a particular direction, in the next cell entry must be 0, then only it can move. Say if it has to move towards this direction, then this must be 0, then only it can move. If it is 1, then it cannot move. So it can move only in this direction or only in this direction by being there in this particular cell, because the rest of all are ones. I hope you understand the particular cell. So with this basic understanding, you will have to have a representation of this understanding. So being there in this particular cell, a row and a column index, I can move in north, east, west, south and other northeast, southeast, southwest and northwest directions. So for example, if being in this direction, being in this particular cell, if it has to move towards north, then row will be decremented and column will be as it is. And if it has to move towards south, row will be incremented and column will be as it is. At the same time, if it has to move towards west, row will be, this is just a simpler two-dimensional matrix, you can understand the indices, then it is quite simple. So row will be as it is, if you move towards left or right, row will be as it is, and column will be decremented by 1, if you are moving towards left or towards west. If you are moving towards east or right, then the column value is going to be incremented. So if you have to move towards northeast, so row will be decremented, column will be incremented by 1. If you are moving towards southwest, southeast, row will be incremented by 1, column will be incremented by 1. So similarly, southwest, row will be incremented by 1, column will be decremented by 1. So northwest, row and column will be decremented by 1. So likewise, you need to have a basic understanding about how a rat can move in which position. So this minus 1, minus 1. This here it is minus 1 plus 0, minus 1 plus 1. So this is the basic understanding which you need for the next slide. So here, if it has to move towards north direction, so you understand that we give the number as 0. North is going to be 0, like north is going to be 0. North is going to be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So totally 8 moves will be there by being there in a particular cell entry. I can have totally 8 directions in I can move. So depending on row is going to be incremented or decremented. So if I have to move in north direction, then I have to decrement row by 1, then the column will be as it is. So here, if you understand here, row will be, so here decremented by 1 and column will be vertical direction and horizontal direction are going to be representing respectively row and column, minus 1 and 0. So if you consider here, the column will be kept or the horizontal direction is going to be kept as it is if it is going to be south, and vertical direction is going to be plus 1. So likewise, all whatever the understanding here it is there in the previous slide, like if you want to move in, say, west direction, this is the direction, 0, minus 1. So if it is west direction, if you are moving in west direction, use the keyboard, in the west direction, row will be as it is and column will be minus 1. So that is what here it is going to be representing it as, row will be minus 1 and column will be 0. So likewise, you are going to understand this particular pattern, plus 1, minus 1 or 0. So depending on that one, you try to make a move in respective directions. So the directions are going to be represented by these things, the offsets. Offsets like vertically, how much it is going to be incremented or decremented, or it is going to be not nullified. So vertical, horizontal value, vertical and horizontal value. So offsets totally, because there will be 8 directions, moves will be totally 8 moves. So here the main problem, now after understanding this and the previous slide, you might have understood that it is going to be a set of moves. Rat is going to have a set of moves, that's all. Array of moves. The mouse is moving. this much is simple basic understanding about the 8 different moves. We try to implement the merging problem or convert these assumptions and fundamentals into a maze problem. It is nothing but array of moves from the set position to the starting position to the end position. If we are at a position maze row column and we wish to find the position of the next move, then it is going to be like this. Using these two steps, the next row will be row plus. You are going to fetch the vertical and horizontal directions from the moves. In which direction, whichever direction I wanted to move, so in that direction I will be fetching the vertex, vertical and horizontal values, and I will be summing up to that one. So that I can go and decide on which next move I want to do. So with this basic understanding, we will move on to the algorithm, how we can define it. So initial attempt at a maze traversal algorithm is maintain a second two-dimensional array mark to record the maze positions. Like in this maze position, say for example, if this 1x1 has been visited already, so I will maintain the same dimensional matrix which will indicate that this particular cell has been visited by marking it as 1. Rest of the entries will be 1. So likewise, I require two dimensional matrix, one which is going to be mentioning the maze, and the other one which is going to mark the traversed cells. Maintain a second two-dimensional array mark to record the maze position already checked in. And also the second thing that I need to understand is I need to maintain a stack. So this stack to keep past history. In whichever cells that I have passed previously before reaching the ultimate destination, I need to memorize all those moves. So to memorize, I need a stack. So stack of moves. So the stack of moves will be row, column and direction, which are going to be encapsulated in the structure and element. And this element stack is going to be a maximum number of moves that we are going to consider in this case is only 100. With this basic understanding, we will move on to the next slide, where say until the stack is empty. Usually the stack is empty and we are going to keep on pushing the moves. And then as and when we move a particular cell, or the rat moves into a particular cell, then we are making that particular cell to be entered into the stack. So currently, say we assume that the stack is going to be empty. Row, column and directory, a triplet, delete from the top of the stack. So capture this particular direction. This is what we assuming that all the moves are there within the stack. So row, column, direction. So while there are more moves from the current position, so as I told, there will be 8 different directions in which the rat can move. So the next row and next column coordinates of the next move. So and the direction is the direction of the move. As I mentioned, in this case, DAR is going to be having around 8 different directions. As I mentioned here, depending on that, vertical and horizontal values will be captured. Yes. So if next row is not going to be my exit row index and next column is not going to be my exit column, so this exit row and exit column is my final destination to where the rat has to move. So if my next move is going to be matching with exit row and exit column, that means the path is or the traversing to the destination is successful. Otherwise, if it returns success, otherwise if not equal to 0. So here maze of next row and next column is equal to 0, in a sense it can pass through, and mark of next row next column is equal to 0. In a sense, this will indicate that it has not already visited, and this will indicate it can pass through. So that is what these two conditions are going to be for. So if both the conditions are going to be satisfied, then it can decide on in which direction it can move. So I will start from the first direction, from the mark direction, mark of next row, next column. So add, I will be adding a point to the stack. Now I will be adding this particular row column. See, if it is a legal move, then I will push it onto the stack, row column and the direction. I push the even the direction onto the stack first, so that if I encounter any path that cannot be traversed anymore, I can retract back. So that is why I add this particular triplet onto the stack. So now I decide on row equal to next row, which I got it from my earlier metric, column and direction. I push it. This is the north direction, so I will push it, and I will keep on doing this particular looping until I reach this particular exit row and exit column. If it is not at all possible, so if this condition. If it is not at all, able to reach the exit row and exit column, then it will say that no path is found. So ultimately, it has to find the path. Otherwise, it will say that it is not able to find the path. No path found. So after here, earlier function was. If you remember, earlier function was like this basic problem. So now the function is after reaching the final exit row and exit column, I need to print the path, output a path to the maze if such path exists from the set source to the set destination. So int I, row, column, these are all the initial variables, declared variables, and I will be there in row as one, column as one, and in the north direction I will be moving. In the direction of one, I will be moving. In the direction of one is, say, in the towards. If you consider the direction one is minus one and one. Minus one to one is, say, here minus one and one is the northeast. If I try to move in the northeast direction, then what will happen to me? So here, that is what it is going to find out. If I try to move in northeast direction, here that is what this 1 is. So then if top is greater than minus 1, and if the path is not yet found, then pop out the topmost element from the stack and store them into the respective row column directions. If next row is exit row and next column is exit column, then you say that the found is true. You found the ultimate destination. If it is not the ultimate destination, then find out, as I told in the previous slides, the maze. Okay, through that maze, the maze of this particular row and column, I can pass through. So the negation condition is 0 indicates 0 negated, it will become true. And here 0, if it is mark of this row and column, if it is 0, and this will be true. If both are 0 and 0, it can pass through, and it was not previously visited, then it can move in the particular direction. And it can go to the, it can store the next row and next column and next direction, and I will push it onto the stack. So likewise, that was the algorithm, and this is the program implementation. Yes, if found, then the path is. How do I print the path is? You 0 to top. So for all the respective paths, I will keep on printing the row, column, the stack of within the stack and the row and column, and the print the row value and the column value, and finally the exit row and exit column. So I will be keeping on printing this so that I can reach the destination. If it is not found, then you say that the maze does not have a path. So we will go through the C program execution, where we can find the implementation of this maze problem. Implementation of this maze problem in C language. Yes, this is the program of maze problem using a stack in C language. So here you find the structure being defined. this vertical and horizontal directions, offsets. Totally there will be, these offsets define the 8 directions, north, east, west, south, etc. Totally 8 directions will be mentioned. And as I told, this triplet, the row, column and the direction will be pushed onto the stack or popped from the stack as and when the rat is going to make a move. And here we require, as I told, the maze matrix is going to be storing the actual maze, and the mark matrix is going to store the cells which is which the rat is going to eject. And initially, to indicate that the stack is empty, top equal to -1. So we are going to read first the maze matrix, like how many number of rows will be there, how many number of columns will be there, and the maze we will read and set the new table, like those 8 directions I need to set, and then push the pop instructions with respect to a stack. And also find path is, as I explained earlier, it is going to start with a particular position like 1, 1, and until it reaches the exit position, it is going to keep on doing this particular process within the loop. Once it finds the path, then it will pop out the respective positions of the path or respective cell indices of the path, and then it is going to print and exit. Print the exit row and exit cell. And else, if it is not reached the exit row and exit column, then it will print the maze doesn't have a path. So, to execute this program and try to execute, understand how this actually works. So, the basic understanding is like it starts with 1, 1, 0 is going to be passing in the maze matrix, 0 is going to be not traversed cell in a mark matrix. So with this understanding, if you run this program, then you need to enter the respective number of rows, the number of columns. Yes, let me open the output terminal. Now I need to enter the number of rows and the number of columns. The number of rows, that say for example I will consider it as 11, and the number of columns that I will consider as 8, say for example. Then I will enter the elements for the maze matrix. This is the maze matrix that I am trying to enter. You find here all the first row, last row, first column and last column are going to be 1, which are going to indicate that those are all the borders. Zeros will be the cell entries which are going to make a pass through, and 1s are the barriers. With that understanding, if I press 1, say it is going to give me the path from the 1, 1 to the path. The ultimate destination is 9, 6. If the path is found, like the path will be like, say from here to like this, and then it will move in this direction, and then like this. So ultimately it reaches here. So that is what this simple program is going to illustrate. So this simple program is going to illustrate that it is going to start from 1, 1 and it is going to end up with 9, 6. So that is the simple understanding of the mazing problem, where you start with two identical matrices, not identical, one is the maze and the another one is mark, which will be serving the different purpose. I hope you understand this mazing matrix. Try to feed the different input and output for this program. This program is available in my GitHub repository. Please try to download and try to execute that program. Then you will feel how this mazing problem is going to work when stack is going to be applicable. Now we move on to the next topic, the multiple stacks and multiple queues. Earlier we discussed about multiple stacks. So earlier we discussed about the stacks, and then we will move on to the multiple queues and multiple stacks. So here, what is a multiple stack is, so when a stack is created using a single array, we cannot be able to store large amount of data. Thus this problem is rectified using more than one stack in the same array. So earlier always we concentrated that within a single dimensional array, always we assumed that there is going to be only one and only one stack that is going to be interpreted. But here in this case what we assume is stack A is going to be stored in one portion of the array, and stack B is going to be stored in another portion of the array. So that is what the multiple stacks is. Similarly, multiple queues. One portion of the array is going to be treated as one of the queue. Another portion is going to be treated as another queue. So it can be not limited to two, but it can be any number of stacks and any number of queues can be treated in a single dimensional array. Say for example, in a single dimensional array of 100 elements. So each 10 elements can be treated as one stack. Each 10 elements. So what it can be 10 stacks, or it can be also be treated as 10 queues. The same kind of operations, push and pop for a queue, N queue and D queue for queues will be applicable in the same time order as we applied in the earlier case. But here if you want to run the program, multiple stack and multiple program, and then you will understand. Here for the sake of simplicity, we will assume that there are only two stacks available within the single dimensional array. So before we move on to the multiple queues, we try to execute the program on multiple stacks. So in this multiple stacks, see, let me open the multiple CID, VS Code IDE, where you get the multiple stack program. So here is the multiple stack program. So here I start with, I'm going to consider one single dimensional matrix as stack, which is going to have a maximum size as a 10. The top of the stack of A, like as a code, I'm going to, for the sake of simplicity, I take only two stacks to be there. Top A equal to minus 1, top B equal to max. So I'll write the push and pop operations for both the first and second stack, A stack and B stack. For the A stack, I'll push the element onto the stack. For A stack, I'll pop out the element from the stack using this particular logic that we talked about again, as I explained earlier with respect to stacks. And similarly, to display the stack A, I need to have a separate function, push and pop operations for pop B. Only thing here it varies is the single dimensional array is going to be treated as two different stacks. The interpretation is going to be different. So when you run this program, then you will feel the actual what is happening. So when run this program, let me switch over to the output window. Yes, output window of this. Just a minute. Here you will be able to observe the menu where it is going to be stating like whether you want to enter or to push the element or pop the element from the stack A or stack B. So I'll enter the choice as stack A. I'll push the element as say 1 1 into the A stack, and I'll enter one more element into the first stack. Say I'll element 1 2. Then I'll element one more element into the stack as say 1 3, and I'll display the stack A. So I'll display the stack A as 5. So 1 1 1 2 1 3 are the elements that are there in the stack A. Now I will push the elements onto the stack A as say I will push the element second. So I will be pushing the elements onto the say 21, and I will enter push the element into the stack B as say 22, and I will enter one more element into the stack as say 33, and I will display the stack B, which is going to be 21 22 33. Now if I delete the element from the stack A, say I will pop out an element from stack A as the 3 option. So I have deleted 33, so the option that I entered was the 3, which is going to pop out the element 33 here. And if I display the stack A, if I display the stack A 5, then it is going to display as 11 12 13. Say if I pop out the element from the other stack, say I will enter the fourth option, and I will enter the option as say 5. Now you observe (11, 12, 13). So likewise, say I will pop out the fourth. So I will display the stack B. I have given the wrong option. So that is how the multiple stacks and multiple queues are going to work with. As I explained earlier, multiple stacks will work in that fashion. Now we move on to multiple queues. Multiple queues will be like this. The front and the rear. Within the n number of elements, I can have n number of queues. Say from this position to this position, I will treat it as one queue. From n plus 1 to 2n, I will treat it as another queue. 2n plus 1 to this position, I will treat it as another queue. Likewise, I can have any number of queues. So similarly, I can have multiple queues. So before concluding, I will go through the multiple queue program. I expect you to run the program from the GitHub repository. The program is available in GitHub repository. Please try to work out that program. Just I will brush up what it is going to be there. So insert queue and insert. Let me go through this. Here I have insert queue and a delete queue functions. The front and rear are going to be there. The respect to how many queues here in this program, you have an option to have how many queues that you want to enter. So I expect you to run this program, create at least 2 to 3 queues within that program, and try to exercise from which queue you are going to insert and from which queue you are going to delete out. Just try to execute by forking my repository in GitHub.